Kick things off, Ashley Brewer, Sports Center anchor for ESPN, also co-host of the NHL Awards. How are you feeling ahead of this awesome event?
Guys, I'm nervous. I don't typically get nervous. I don't get nervous for TV. I don't know about you guys, but like, as we've done our rehearsals, as we started talking about it, I'm talking to Keenan and I'm like, oh my goodness, this is a big deal. And I'm like, well, I'm going to make myself cry tonight.
But you will. Like, you do have that ability to like bring that emotion across. Yeah. And these are a lot of stories that are very emotional. It's a different layout inside there, though. It kind of looks like a wedding.
Yes, I thought so too. But I like that because it's intimate. It's personal. I'm like eye to eye with Austin Matthews. And I'm like, you represent for Arizona. Yeah. Okay. I love it. Sure. I know. So it's cool.
I would be a little more nervous if I was potentially winning an award tonight, because you're gonna really be able to see
everyone.
Every single person.
I love what's like,
oh gosh,
do you think they get nervous for awards?
Because
absolutely. It's just like you were saying, right? When you're on TV, there's maybe a handful of people in the studio with you. When you're on a stage, you see the, oh, there's actual humans here watching me. Like, this is a real thing.
So, and for us, like, we love to talk. That's who we are. We're people, people, whatever. But these guys, sometimes English isn't their first language. Sometimes they're more on the reserve side. So they're
Or they're hockey players and they're just, they're going to answer whatever they want. They're going to say whatever they want to say, no matter what you ask them.
So I'm really looking forward to seeing it. It's going to be fun.
I can't wait. Five awards being handed out tonight. Is there one that you're looking forward to the most? I know you mentioned Austin Matthews, the heart maybe going to an Arizona kid.
The heart, the Ted Lindsay. I think the Ted Lindsay is really important because it's voted on by other players. And so I'm excited to see, you know, who the players respect and the performance that they respect the most. But there's so many incredible players, so many great moments. I see Trevor Zegras and I'm like,
he's got a good suit on.
I'm so excited. So
are we getting him? He's walking the other way.
Okay. Well, thank you so much for joining us. We can't wait to see you up there.
You're going
to
crush it.
You
are
a bright shining star on and off TV. Whoop. And I'm just going to, and I'm not. I'm not. But thank you, Ashley, for joining us.
Thank you, guys.
Good luck at your show.
Out of the heat.
Yes.
Enjoy. Thank you,
See you, Ashley.
She's just Ashley Brewer. Gem. She's literally like the nicest person in the world, like sweetest, kindest. Same on air as you see off air.
She's a great example of sort of like the hockey and sports community being so small. Like, I just met Ashley for the first time. I feel like I've known her for
forever.
A decade because of our exchanges.
Come on
online.
Down.
Oh, look who it
is.
Zegras in the house.
Yeah.
What's going on? Welcome to our not red carpet, red carpet
the
show.
Brick carpet.
Oh, I love it. It looks great.
Right?
Here, put that bad boy closer
it's
to your
It's hot out here.
It is.
I know.
We won't keep you too long because it is very hot, but take
what
us to the
this?
Outfit because this is a choice. I'm into it.
Mm-hmm. So, I don't know. I just kind of went with the green with a little bit of orange because of the ducks, obviously.
Okay.
Yeah.
I went with the brown shoes. I knew it was going to be hot, so I went with the white shirt, you know.
Okay.
What do you mean you went with it? Like, is there like a designer or are you just like Gilly? Anaheim Ducks PR, get me this awesome suit.
It was kind of a team effort. You know, my mom helped out a little bit, you know, obviously.
Is your mom here?
She is here.
Okay, awesome, awesome.
So, I don't know. I knew it was going to be hot, so I tried to keep it a little loose. That's what I went with.
What's it like being here, like, while the Stanley Cup is going on?
Yeah, I mean, it's really cool. I mean, I've only been to Tampa, I think, one other time. So, obviously, it's nice to get the good weather and Tampa won the last two Stanley Cups, so it's pretty cool, I guess, to be here.
It's cool. It's not, like, weird? Like,
you're going to go to the game?
No, I don't think so. I'm leaving tomorrow.
Oh, you're just right out here. You're like, let me get my shine on.
Would it be weird to go to a game? Would you be like...
Maybe. That might be a little weird.
I feel like it'd be weird.
But I got some buddies. I got some buddies on both teams.
Because you'd be like, I want to be there.
Yeah.
I don't know. I don't think it would be weird.
Support some old teammates.
Yeah, I mean... Corey Perry, I assume you crossed paths with him.
Yeah, I know Perry's a little bit. Obviously, Josh Manson on Colorado.
Yes, yeah.
I kind of grew up knowing Alex Newhook on.
Oh, right.
Okay, that's true, too.
I don't know, Zegras, if you know, I'm a bit of an Anaheim Ducks legend myself.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
I did not know that.
Whoa, you didn't? Really, really humble about it.
What humbles me is standing in the rocks right here on this
I would take the rocks over the sun directly in my left eye.
Yes, a bit of a legend back in my day has a reporter there. But, you know, you're too young to remember that. But we love that you're here joining us. And
let me ask you really quick just about your season. I mean, you're at the NHL Awards because you went highlight reel so many times. You had a hell of a season. The Ducks, I think, were a bit of a surprise to start the year as well. Yeah. Like, if you could put into words what this year has meant to you, how would you describe it?
Yeah, I mean, it was pretty special. Obviously, with Getzlaf kind of having his last season, it was cool to be a part of that.
Yeah.
And, kind of the way he kind of took us young guys in down the stretch was pretty special. And overall, it was just a fun year. Obviously, being in California and the great weather is unreal. So I don't know. All in all, I think it was a lot of fun. Yeah.
Well, tell Kent French and Johnny Allers and Brian Hayward we say hello. We're big fans on Stanley Cup Live.
Oh yeah.
Right.
Oh yeah.
Okay. Congratulations on a really solid year.
Thank you. Thank you. I appreciate
it. Have fun tonight.
Yeah. Thank
you. Get out of the heat. We'll melt. You don't have to.
I'm going back inside.
You're more important than us.
Cheers. And you can hand that off to that gentleman over there, our boss slash PA. Oh, Trevor Zegras, quite the legend.
I love you, pumping your own tires.
You know what? I give zeros right now. So if I'm gonna fall into these rocks here on the red carpet, I'm gonna reminisce about the glory days.
Bring them on it. Oh, no, let them chat. Let them chat. Keenan Thompson to the side, hanging out with Trevor Zegras.
What happens on Stanley Cup Live is it's live. You see, you don't even know which camera you're looking at, so it's all just in the moment. We see who's up. Oh,
we're talking to legends.
No, listen, come on in. You go in the center.
Come on in.
It's about you. I'm good. How are you? It's good to see you.
Hi, Jack. Really nice to see you.
We won't keep you out here long, because as you can see, we're melting.
I know. Yep. I want to keep you out here long. Let's get this done.
Literally,
we're out here for an hour, so it's over for us. But it's not over for you.
It is. I know it's just beginning.
How pumped are you to be back here hosting this thing? A little bit different this year. How does this change sort of how you approach this crowd?
Yeah, it's a little more intimate. So I think I'm going to do a lot of elbow rubbing beforehand to make sure we're all on the same page.
I see what you mean.
Get everybody in the mood to have a good time, you know what I mean?
You like me, don't forget.
Come on, we need that energy. Just laugh even if you don't think it's funny.
Yeah, no, that's true, because you got the crowd here. You were on our show Third Period Live on NHL.
Yeah,
you came
awesome.
To us from the Rangers game. Mm-hmm. We know that the Rangers lost, unfortunately, but you said you got some inspiration from being there.
I did. I mean,
did any of that make its way into the final cut?
Well, I don't want to make jokes, but I was very inspired to see how those guys like put it all out there like that. You know what I mean? It was a great series, and they've come a long way, and you know, Tampa stood up and did their thing. So yeah, I'm excited to see where this final is going to go, because if they could do it again, that would be insanely incredible. So I don't know. I'm just excited right now. They had a good win yesterday. I got to skate on that ice this morning.
You did. How was that? It was
so
a good skate.
Smooth. Yeah, it was beautiful. Unbelievable. Super smooth.
Yeah. No issues.
No issues.
Well, yeah,
at
you
all.
Got the, you know, the old knuckle puck. You try that out there?
No, I didn't get a stick and a puck, unfortunately. they didn't really want me to skate.
It was literally just a little
skate. They were nervous that I would fall, but they must not know, dog. Yeah. They don't know me.
What? D2, D3?
That's right. Both of them. Come on.
Get with it. Get with it.
That's right.
Obviously, we have a series now. You mentioned that, the Stanley Cup Final.
Yeah.
You know, you look at some of the characters in this Stanley Cup Final. Mm-hmm. You got the likes of a Patty Maroon. Like, when you look at some of the brighter person, you were just talking to one, Trevor Zegras, right? Bright personality. Mm-hmm. Are you seeing that more and more in hockey? And what characters sort of stand out to you coming into this night?
I mean, Trevor's one for sure. You know, just a lot of these guys are just young, you know, and they got a lot of flash in their life, and that's really cool to witness. I mean, I've been watching a lot of the diversity of it all, you know what I mean? Like, mm-hmm. it's really cool to see. Like, the Rangers got a couple few, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying?
Need more.
But
need more.
Yeah, it's just nice to see, like, the inclusion of it all and, like, you know, the outward reach and all that. I mean, we're honoring a guy who does a lot for diversity tonight. So, you know, I mean, it's a very cool thing to witness, but as far as, like, swagger goes, you know, it's nice to see the young guys because Ovechkin is just going to be there with his shirt off laying with the trophy and stuff like that. He's not really going to dress it up.
Yeah, we need some more action. You know, you're hosting tonight. Can you give people just, like, an idea of what, you know, you might be working on, what they might see?
Yeah, I mean, it's going to be quick, you know. It's mostly about these guys, you know, and patting them on the back. It's not about me. I got a couple jokes or whatever, but, yeah, we're going to get in and get out. And, do some good for the community that's doing so good for the league, you know?
You're underselling. A couple jokes or whatever.
I'm so pumped.
A couple jokes.
Every weekend on Saturday night.
Oh, thank you
very
much.
My boyfriend and I, we watch every single episode.
Thank you. Yes. There's a pre-tape in there. We did do one good there.
All right, well, listen, we don't want you to melt out here.
No, we won't.
I like the shoes, by the way.
Man,
I know.
Thank you.
Yeah, take
those?
A look at these sneaks.
Get those. Represent.
They're on fire.
I'm going to get mine out because mine are super cat.
Come on.
You're
killing.
Keenan, thank you so much.
Thank you so very
much.
You guys enjoy. Finish up. Get back in the AC.
Yeah.
Love everybody.
We're going to, seriously.
Yeah. A frozen towel. Cheers.
Thank you for coming on the show.
My pleasure. Have a good one.
Good luck, man.
Kenan Thompson.
Yes, awesome. I love always telling people what a big fan I am of theirs in that moment, and then it's like seeing how they react.
The guests continue. Hello, sir. How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
It's hot.
It is
but
hot.
So we're going to try not to keep you out here very long
because
you're in all black here. But take us, I mean, this is a nice
I've never actually seen a one lapel.
Thank you. Yeah, I appreciate it. Yeah, I thought this would be a good occasion to take that out.
Oh,
sorry. Be a good occasion to pull out the suit, so, but it is a little hot.
Yeah, a little bit.
Yeah.
Stitch.
So what are you looking forward to most about the awards here tonight?
Well, it's my first award show, so it's pretty special just to be here and see all the guys and just the whole show. I think I've watched it on TV a couple of times, so it's a pretty cool show, and yeah, obviously excited to be nominated.
Is it odd, like, seeing guys here? Like, is there someone's autograph you would want?
Maybe.
And also, yeah.
Maybe a selfie. I'd be like selfie.
Yeah,
like
sorry. Do you have your autograph book? Like, you're at Disney
World? I didn't
bring
my autograph book, but you know what?
Like, outdated.
It is funny because you play against those guys all the time, but you look up to them. I mean, they're unbelievable players, so you do respect what they do on the ice, and I guess you are kind of a bit of a fan. You're a player, but also a fan.
So who? So maybe name a name, like.
I'm gonna try to get Austin Matthews' autograph. Yeah, I saw him earlier, so I'm gonna
really
try to get that.
He's really panned
just
out.
Just keep your Sharpie with you, and you never know what could happen.
Well, let me ask you this: this year was, I know it's such a team sport, and you guys remind us all the time in interviews, right? It's about the crest on the jersey, but this year was so solid for individual performances, especially on the back end as well. Like, what did you make just of this season as a whole, and some of the performances that we saw?
Yeah, I mean, there was a lot of great performances, a lot of records being broken, and like I said, I think as a player it's so cool. I think just on defense with Kale and Victor having these unbelievable seasons, it's kind of pushes you, and like I think we all appreciate.
You like want to keep up, right?
Yeah, yeah. We all appreciate what the other guy's doing, and you see other guys doing so great. So I think in some way it pushes you, and it's a lot of fun, obviously, to be part of that.
Is that what it's like being here with the Stanley Cup in town? You're kind of like, ooh, what if I was in town for that too?
Yeah, you would want to be in town for that. For sure. That's the main goal, to be part of that. So you're definitely a little jealous of those guys.
Yeah, it keeps you firing a bit.
Yeah, I'll just ask you one more because I know it's hot and you have more important things to do than hang out with us. If you were to win an award tonight, would you be nervous for the speech? Is it prepared? Like, how do you approach that?
I didn't prepare that much, but I would definitely be a little nervous.
Yeah.
I feel like everyone gets a little nervous speaking in front of people. And I would be lying if I said I wasn't nervous.
For sure.
Yeah.
Understandably
like hearing
so.
Your name, I feel like you're like, oh, God. Get tense.
Yeah.
I don't know about you guys.
Yeah, it's like, don't forget to thank your parents.
Yeah, you
got to
think of everyone.
Yeah, you know, you got to get everyone in there.
Yeah.
All right, listen, congratulations on such a solid season. We'll get you back inside because we know.
I know, good luck tonight.
Thank you, I appreciate it.
Cheers.
Congrats.
Cheers.
Thanks, guys.
I love the one lapel.
You can hand your mic to Matt over there.
Yeah.
Whew.
Thanks so much.
How are you doing? Welcome to our.
I was going to cheers you to start, but I realize that's what our goodbye. Yes, yeah. So, okay, take us through what you're wearing here tonight.
I've been using the same suit guy for a few years, Dom from Tijuana, so he's from Montreal. I don't know exactly all the details, but yeah.
So are you like you're a pinstripe guy, or is this like your first time in pinstripes?
Actually, first time in pinstripes.
Oh, first time in pinstripes.
Yeah, you're pulling it off.
Yeah, thank you.
Yeah, and the double-breasted action. What do you think of everyone else's suits here so far?
It looks good so far, especially the teammate Roman is really pulling it off.
I know.
Yeah.
He's got the one single lapel, as we're saying.
I think that was pretty cool.
Yeah.
I give him a lot of credit for standing out here in all black with the sun on him. But, like, what did you think of his season this year? I mean, an unbelievable performance from Roman Josi.
Yeah, obviously, like you said, really unbelievable and really backbone of our team. So, also really fun to play with him. And, yeah, it was pretty special to see him play that kind of season.
How are you feeling? I know you're a little banged up before.
Yeah, I'm getting there. I've been training and rehabbing the ankle in Nashville, and probably like a week or two away from being like fully healthy.
Oh, nice. Yeah. Okay, that's great. We have a lot of fans of you in the house. They were like, I hope he's okay. So that's good to hear.
Yeah.
All right, well, listen, congratulations on being here. Enjoy the night. We don't want
whose autograph do you want tonight?
Yeah, that's a tough question.
Right?
I gotta think about it.
See, I think autographs are outdated. I
no,
think
I'm bringing,
about the
I'm bringing an autograph back.
You're yeah. trying.
I'm gonna sell autograph yeah. books to people here. Just bring a Sharpie out. But yeah, who's a selfie you'd want to get with someone here?
Maybe like Kenan Thompson would be a good
yeah,
one,
that would be
right?
cool. Yeah, I gotta kind of scroll around who we got
yeah.
here.
Yeah, probably yeah. not someone that scored on you, right? Or no, or maybe.
Yeah, I don't really care.
Yeah,
I don't hold crutch.
I like this guy. Yeah, yeah. Just roll right off your back. Yeah. Okay, awesome stuff. Well, enjoy tonight here yeah. at the NHL Awards, and
thanks for hanging yeah. out.
Thank you.
Cheers. Appreciate okay. it.
Cheers.
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 Cheers. Cheers. Your mic off
yeah,
too.
Sounds yes. good.
To Matt on your way back into the air conditioning.
Well, that's great. Great news, UC Soros. Only a
week or two away.
Breaking news here lots on Stanley Cup Live.
Lots of time to train.
Yeah,
year,
yeah,
right?
yeah. We so. Have a lot of Predators fans in the crowd. They're asking me, oh, I hope he's okay. And I was like, okay, I will get to the bottom of that.
We'll find out. I will yeah. find out. Well, I'll tell you what. Like, it's so funny listening to someone like Roman. I know Ashley talked about being a little bit nervous, but for someone like Roman Josi to be like,
I know.
Yeah, you know. Little nervous.
It is so true, though. Like, just the idea of when you're like everyone out there, you're speaking in front of other people. It's like, make my sentence make sense. Don't start. I start a sentence hoping to find it somewhere along the way, to quote the great Michael Scott. But when I used to do Anaheim Ducks, as I mentioned, doing the in arena interviews was always like my gut punch moment, because it's like, you don't want those 25,000 people to hear you stumble or say or like forget a word or just like go blank.
And you just don't want to forget someone important, right? Like, I would imagine that in that moment, especially if you're a first-time award winner, you're probably like so excited but also nervous that you almost like black out just a little
bit. Blackout.
And it could be very easy to forget to thank someone important, because you're just like, you're literally in the moment, you know? So.
Yeah. Well, we're pretty pumped to welcome on in. Come on in,
come
Moritz
on in. Hello,
Sider.
I'm Jackie. Nice to meet you.
I'm Julie. Nice to meet you. Sorry for everyone. We just got a drone that's going. I was like, is that a vacuum
over
cleaner
there.
Over there? Just a casual drone. How are you feeling? You're at the NHL Awards first time. What's the vibe like?
It's great. It's super hot out here, so I was really happy we were inside. I'm just really happy to be here and very honored, and I'm looking forward to tonight.
As you should be. I mean, your first time here, you're nominated for an award. If you were to win, have you prepared a speech or no? Are you just going to wing it?
Actually, I don't even think or thought about that. So I just go with
you're
the flow.
I like that. I respect that move. Like, just get up there and say what's in your heart, right?
Yeah. Exactly. If you prepare, is that almost like bad luck?
Yeah, probably. I think if you're too confident, you just might get disappointed, so.
Right, yeah, because you're already, well, or visualizing. I feel like you could battle.
Maybe something in between.
You could battle both sides.
You gotta find the middle ground.
Award speech writing 101. Yeah.
As a player, are you superstitious?
I think everyone is a little bit.
But no one wants to talk about it. Will you talk about it with us?
Yeah, it's not too crazy. I just love playing soccer. That basic stuff, so.
Okay.
And.
Who's your club?
Munich, obviously.
So. Okay, so you would know Alfonso Davies.
Of course.
We're from Canada.
Yeah.
So he's our
guy
for the World
huge
Cup.
Star.
Talking
big
soccer
time
on a
star.
Hockey
yeah,
show.
100%.
Yeah. Canada soccer, though, pretty good, eh?
They qualified, right?
Yeah, I had to. They beat the U.S. in qualifying. Yeah, so Germany better watch
something.
Out.
That's something.
Yeah.
Oh, my gosh. There's, Julie is huge into soccer. We've worked soccer into almost every show that we've done. We're doing a show
a
every day
of
the Cup
Final.
Up,
to be honest.
This is true.
Yeah.
This is true.
There's connections between both.
Yeah. Well, you're here for the NHL Awards, and there's so many big name players in there, guys that you've played against. Is there anyone in there who you're just like, you have so much respect for that you're excited to meet?
Everyone, but if I have to pick one, it's probably Roman Josi.
Okay.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. Had a chance to meet him for a second. And then hopefully touch base again.
You gonna get a selfie?
Yeah, maybe. I don't know if he will let me or not.
Oh my gosh, you totally will.
But all in all, I'm just very happy to be here.
And what about the other guys you're in the category with? Michael Bunting, Trevor Zegras. Like, what do you think of them?
Oh, tremendous players. I think everyone deserves to be here. Obviously, I always pumped the tires for Lucas too. But I think everyone is very happy with the finalists, and I'm just wishing everyone good luck tonight.
Okay, so question about Detroit. What is like your go-to best place in Detroit for all of our big Detroit Red Wings fans out there?
It's a place Dylan brought me, right, I think on the first or second day, called The Market.
Okay.
Super basic, but it's just so delicious. And
what is it?
Everything. It's a bar restaurant mix, I think. Okay. It's just casual, good food. All in all,
have you been to Cafe Domingo?
Oh no,
no! Oh, you gotta go there. Okay. It's wild.
Alrighty.
Good music.
Okay.
Like, wild scene. There's like old ladies serving behind the bar. They got like Motown music. It's a scene in Detroit.
It's on the list.
Yeah, it's on the list.
Well, listen, congratulations again. We're gonna get you back inside. We're trying not to keep guys out here too long because, as you can tell, it's very hot. But I need you to do me a favor. Alex Tangay is my guy. I used to work with him at NHL Network, so. If you see him or you're chatting with him, just tell him I said to get his shit together.
All right.
Okay? Just tell him I said that.
Swear.
It's too late.
Jackie Redmond.
Yeah.
Just if you're remembering to tell Alex.
Oh, yeah, that's right. That's right.
I don't know. He obviously knows who you are. She's the host of NHL on NHL Network.
Of course. Of course.
Just give Tangs a little crap for me, all right?
I give him a hat.
All right. Congratulations again. Enjoy the night.
Cheers. Thank you.
Cheers. You can hand your mic off.
Go get that selfie with Roman Josi.
He's like the nicest guy in the league.
Get an autograph. David Amber, welcome on in. The
gracing
one and
us
only.
With your presence in this heat.
Yeah.
I'm out of here.
We're melting, David.
Yeah.
You guys look great, by the way.
Yeah.
The dress. If I could dress like that, I got.
You know what? You
I'm
can dress like this, David. I'm trying to bring sparkles to the league. You haven't noticed.
Bedazzled.
I heard that Mikhail Sergachev would be a guy that would wear a sparkly blazer.
Really?
Yeah.
Elliot Friedman would be a guy who'd wear a sparkly.
You think?
Yeah, he would.
Do you think he'd rock? He'd probably rock sequins.
He looks good tonight, though. He's got a tuxedo on. Is he on the show
him.
Yet?
We'll
get him out here. We'll get him out here next. He looks
good. Get him in the heat.
Yeah. So you're here at the awards. It's on Sportsnet. Mm-hmm. What are you looking forward to about this? Whatever that was on
my leg.
Dead. Done. It's dead.
Amber just took care of business.
It's out. Out.
Oh, have you seen the Bo Burnham outcuts? It's like everyone's a feminist until there's a spider around. Yeah. That was literally that
killer,
moment. Okay, back to action. What about this? What are you looking forward to about this iteration of the NHL Awards?
Well, I mean, I think there's going to be some really highly contested awards. Like, you know, who's going to win the MVP, right? Who's going to win the Ted Lindsay? Who's going to win the Norris, right? Mm-hmm. Like, you have these great guys going head-to-head. I think that's really exciting. I think some of the presenters, too, like Martin LaFleur is going to be out here.
Yeah.
You know, it's just so nice to keep the legacy and the thoughts alive with Guy and everything he did for the game. So I just think it's really cool. There's some really nice stories that will be presented as well. So it's nice. It's nice to see the community together, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, there is a lot of that. I'm so happy that, and I'm blanking on her name right now, but the woman from Vancouver who helped the trainer. Yes. Nadia, that is her name. Yeah. She's here tonight.
That's
and I mean, what
story.
An incredible story that was. I mean, literally life-altering. So I'm excited that she's here as well and being a part of this.
Steve Mayer's done a great job because they picked all these people who've meant so much to the hockey community. I just was talking to the Willie O'Ree winners from the last couple of years. And, you know, these are guys who are growing the game, right? You got another bug in your hand.
Oh, yeah.
You're just a magnet right now.
You have sweet blood, okay? Not that
But, I mean, that's really cool because I think that's a big part of it. It's about celebrating the greatness of the players and the greatness of the game, but it's also let's expose as many people to the game
Definitely.
As possible. And
yes.
There's some, you know, franchises, or not franchises, there's been people who've been sort of disenfranchised from being part of the hockey community, and these guys are bringing them in. So I think it's awesome.
And kind of taking the whole, well, like the awards in Vegas was great and fun, but kind of taking that pomp and circumstance out of it, it makes it, as you said, like the grassroots feeling, the feeling of like, we don't need to spend all our money on all this kind of stuff to make it a big deal. Like, we connect with people that matter and, like, promote people that matter. And I like that vibe that Mayor was talking about with this because it's a different intimate setting in there. It feels like a wedding.
It is, isn't it?
Which is
it, exactly.
Also wild. It's like waiting for, like, a surprise wedding to happen.
I just feel like it changes the game for speeches a little bit because it's so much more intimate. You can't just, like,
but
stare
nice.
To the back of the crowd, but it is nice,
right? You know
right?
What's nice? Like, we were just talking to David Poile. He's here. He's got UC Saros and Roman Josi up for awards. Like, it's a bit of a family affair. I just saw the whole Matthews family is here. You know, this is a big moment, right? Like, think about all the energy, all the time, the commitment it takes to get to the
Lifelong
level of these
journey.
Players. Lifelong journey. And to see it, you know, like, this is the crowning jewel for a lot of these guys. So just to be part of that and be there, it's amazing.
I got to ask you who some of your picks are.
Picks
like,
for
the North. Let's start with the Norris. What do you think?
I'm going to say Roman Josi.
Okay.
And again, remember, this was a regular season award. That's
Votes
gotta,
were
gotta
placed
remember.
Before
everyone
the playoffs started.
I'm confused about that.
And that's obviously, look, it could go either way. And, you know, anyone, the three finalists are all incredible candidates, and Cale Makar is going to win this award several yes. times. I'm confident of that. But I do think Roman Josi, the impact he had when he was on the ice for this team was, you know,
yeah,
it was incomparable. That's my feel on it.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. Well, we know you have to get going. Mm. I just got word from our producer over there, okay. who's no longer there anymore. but David, you do such a great job. Congratulations to your daughter, just graduated.
Yeah,
right?
High school grad. Oh my
nice.
God, I'm getting old.
Yeah, because I know he's working the playoffs and then went home and then came back.
I went home between game yeah. one and two, went back home, and my daughter Jacqueline graduated high school. I was very
great
proud
name.
Of her. And yeah,
great
yeah.
name. Great name.
And yeah. And she's excited. So next phase will be college, and it's like, oh my God, I'm gonna have a kid in college.
Where yeah. does she know where she's going to go yet?
She's going to McGill University in
oh,
Montreal.
Nice.
So
oh, nice.
I went there and my wife went there, so
oh,
it's kind of,
nice.
Let's keep the generations going there.
That's
I don't know.
That's great. Well, I went to Queens, so a little
oh,
rivalry.
Oh, I didn't know
Annie's
that.
Out. Annie's out.
I know. Cheers, David.
Cheers, guys.
Cheers.
Thank you
Enjoy.
For
you can
pass
dealing
that.
With the heat
I
for our
you
show.
Doing, you're doing amazing.
Yeah.
Yeah. Be well, guys.
Thank you so much, David. Yeah, it's pretty bad back there. Yeah. I'm glad I'm not wearing silk. It's my, this whole thing.
Literally dripping the back of my dress. Is just drenched
it's
in
drenched.
Sweat.
It's like,
you know what? I'm just going to own it right now. It is. It's
yeah, let's,
just.
All those weirdos out there, let's look at all of our sweat all over us.
It's so hot. This was
it's
not
so
a
hot.
Choice.
I'm really glad we decided to do this out here like this right now. But that's, yeah. I have so many hair extensions in right now. I feel like it's like a forest underneath, a forest fire under my neck right now.
Yes. It's,
yes.
It is. It's hot. I need you to.
I've been shielding you right here, but David Amber's super awesome. When I had the Rona in the first round, he was so nice. He was like, anything you need, like, I'll go get it for you, whatever you want. And it's like, I don't even know him as well as, like, my friends or something. And for him to just, like, reach out, it's like, oh, man, that guy is super nice.
He is got to be up there for one of the nicest guys in the business,
yeah,
David Amber.
Yeah.
Always says hello. Like,
yes.
The first time he meets you, remembers your name,
yes,
then on
yes.
out. Like, just a really, really, really great guy. And I love that he's become such a face of hockey in Canada.
I know. He's done a great job on Hockey Night in Canada. And, like, they've done such an awesome job, too. They're everyone on that panel has been, including Bieksa, who I said, if there was anyone in the NHL to get a wedgie, it would be him.
That's true.
He's done a great job on that panel.
He brings a little bit of real, like, personality
yeah, yeah.
to it, right? And I love the banter between him and Elliot Friedman. I think
yeah.
they have a really good thing going. So yeah, it's been it's great to see new players or
yeah,
more recently
in.
Retired players getting into the mix. Justin Williams just
yes,
started on
yeah.
NHL Network.
Yeah.
And he is really excited to be here and covering the final. And he's, I mean,
what,
if
a,
there's
what
someone,
a way to get, it's like he's getting his debut in the final.
I know.
Wild.
But I mean, it's fitting, right? Mr. Game 7.
I know. He should be in for Game 7. Just like start your TV debut.
Yeah.
But he's great on air. And wow, we are smoking
so
out here.
We are struggling for you
we're
guys. Big time. Big
but
time.
That's great because this is what it's about. Award season. Imagine this was like the Emmys or the Oscars or something. Like those people are out there interviewing like for hours.
Are they like a little shaded though?
Maybe.
I feel like there's a little more.
Jackie and I are kind of out in the brickworks. I don't even know. Like, am I even in the light? I feel like I'm just in the like the trees back here.
How much more time do we have? Oh, a lot.
No,
okay.
Vamp. It was said, the words were rap and vamp. And I was like,
oh,
all right.
Okay. Like,
vamp.
I love all of you guys that tune in, but.
Guys, can you tell us what do you want to know from some of the guests that we're going to get or from Jackie and I? Just like anything. Because we were right about game three, just so everyone remembers.
Yeah, we were finally not wrong. We were right.
So we don't have to wear those shirts next game.
No, we do not.
Isn't that odd?
Like, it is weird. I'm a little, it's going to be very unique and different.
Yeah, we'll see what happens game five because we will be going back to Denver.
Yes, officially, but
officially.
We'll see. We have ourselves a series, we think, but I still think Tampa needs a win tomorrow or it could still be a short
series.
I
also think that too. It's like they got to win tomorrow or
yeah.
this could be a five game type of deal.
Yeah.
But we're looking forward to talking to Austin Matthews. And who else do we see come in here already?
Well, I have not seen anyone else that we have not already
Austin
talked
Matthews.
To. But
oh, yes. Awesome.
Okay, great.
We're about to get Austin Matthews and Michael Bunting.
They'll be on the way.
Yeah.
I am.
And we're pumped about that. I'm just, like, standing here dancing.
Dripping in sweat.
Because what else do you do when you're on a brick carpet out in the sun with
5,000 hair extensions in.
It's and so bad.
A sequined polyester dress. Let's talk about the awards.
Let's talk about the game. Yeah. Or the awards. You know, I think Austin Matthews and Michael Bunting, I mean, two incredible seasons, right? Austin Matthews up for the Hart, Michael Bunting up for Rookie of the Year. They're making their way over here to set
all
right,
right
now.
All
we
right.
appreciate Step the heck in. Out of you guys. You guys
come
go
on
in the
down.
Middle. We know you how hot it is out
is
here.
Right.
So we'll make it quick.
Yeah.
So,
hot out here.
Oh, I'm melting.
How
actually
how are you
melting.
Feeling, guys?
Feeling good, yeah.
Yeah, feeling good. Excited for tonight.
A little
Big
nervous?
Looks great.
Yeah, my boy Mike Paul from Toronto hooked me up. You did a pretty good job.
Here, hold this. You both look great.
Closer, yeah, yeah, yeah. Okay, yeah.
You both look great. So give that shout out again, because I'm not sure the mic was close
my
enough.
Boy, Mike Paul from Toronto hooked me up pretty nicely. So I cleaned up pretty good, I think.
And Austin, what are you wearing
bad.
Here right
I'm wearing,
now?
I think I'm wearing Gucci head to toe, if I'm being completely honest
with
you. Ooh, yeah.
I love that.
Yeah.
Can we zoom in on the Gucci shoes
you
down
there? You
got
the shoes
yeah.
in?
Oh, my gosh, yeah.
I don't know if
no, they're cozy, so yeah.
Yeah, they're comfortable, which is more than I can say right now.
It is pretty hot out here. Okay, you've done this scene before. What have you told this guy about the awards circuit?
I haven't told him anything. I'm just going to let him figure it all out on his own. And it'll be a good night, though. It'll be a lot of fun for the both of us. So I'm looking forward to it. But he doesn't need any advice. He's fine.
Yeah.
Agreed.
I agree. But, no, he's been great to me all year, welcoming me into Toronto. And yeah, he's an unbelievable guy off the ice, and he's all right on the ice. So it's been a lot of fun to play with him.
And a heck of a year for both of you, obviously, or you wouldn't be here. Like, how would you guys describe how your friendship has grown? Like, what when you guys get together away from the rink, what are you guys doing? Video games?
Just talking
concerts.
Smack.
Okay.
You know, it was actually, we have a pretty close mutual friend, so
okay.
I hadn't met him before him coming to Toronto, but just heard a lot about him, and some good, some bad, but
you no,
yeah.
take the good with the bad.
Yeah,
that's like true friendship,
bad.
Right?
No, I mean, it was. He's a great guy. He's easy to hang out with. I think we, you know, kind of have similar interests in different things, and so yeah, it's you know playing together. We spend a lot of time together outside of the rink as well, so it's been a lot of fun.
Yeah, last time I saw you guys was in the first round. I unfortunately got COVID, but I was covering you guys, and thankfully didn't give it to you. I just like to tell everyone that's why I was not in for the rest of the round. But it was here you were against Tampa. What's it like? What does it feel like to be back here? Sorry to bring up my old wound.
Yeah, obviously being back here is a little bittersweet. Obviously you're coming back for the awards, and it's going to be a great night. But I think both of us can say that we wish we were playing. And but you know Tampa's a great team, and once again they're in the finals. So
let me ask you guys this: Jared Bednar, head coach of the Avs, said that they specifically looked at Tampa's series against you guys for clues on how to compete. I mean, I know you guys would rather be here, but I think that's a pretty high compliment coming from the coach to say publicly, right? It's one thing behind closed doors to be like, the Leafs gave this team hell. What did they do? What did you guys think of that?
Yeah, I mean, I think it's nice to hear. I mean, it's. You know, I think there's a lot of similarities between our team and maybe Colorado's, but like you said, I mean, we obviously much rather be playing right now and hopefully a different situation. But you know, life goes on. It's a big honor to be here, and you know, I know for the both of us, it's we're just looking forward to tonight and you know, just having fun.
Does it kind of sting? When we're from Toronto, so when we hear John Cooper say, "Oh, Toronto gave us the hardest," that you're like.
Thanks, Coop.
Thanks.
Yeah, that's, you know, it's obviously nice of him to compliment us like that. And, you know, that's a good thing for our team. And we can look forward to next year with, you know, with him saying that kind of stuff about us.
Last one for you guys. I know I saw your family come in with you, Austin. I don't know if your family's here, but they are such a huge part of the whole journey, right? What does it mean for you guys to have to be able to bring them to a big event like this and share it with them?
Yeah, it's special. I mean, you know, they play such a big role and growing up and just being able to be in the situation that I'm in. And I think I speak for Mike as well. So it's special being able to share this experience with them and have them here. And, you know, these are memories
they
that
kind of give you any advice for like a speech, potential speech?
No advice on that. They just go up there and
How
be
about
yourself.
Biebs? Any advice from him on what to say?
No advice.
Maybe just like, get out of the sun because
yeah.
we've let you.
Yeah,
out.
Stop sweating.
I'm cooking up. I'm
like,
cooking
not
up a
sure
bit.
If this is the interview or the sun right here.
Tough day to wear black.
what's a selfie you'd want to get with someone here? You got to name somebody.
I don't know who's here, to be honest.
Keenan Thompson is like an obvious one, I think.
Yeah,
right?
I would say
there's Kale McCarr.
Maybe a selfie with Kale McCarr. Yeah.
Yeah, for sure. Why not?
I'm asking people whose autograph they want, you know? Because
everyone gets autographs these days.
It's a big fan fest.
Congratulations to you both.
Thanks,
we're
going
to get you guys
inside.
We know it's hot, so we appreciate the time. Enjoy the evening with your family, so, right?
Thanks a lot.
Yeah,
thank
you. Good luck, you guys. Thanks for your mic to Matt.
Hope you guys can get some air conditioning.
I don't think that's in our budget.
I can't get out of here fast enough. I'm not going to lie to you guys.
Yeah, here, we'll take that from you. Thank you.
Have a good time.
Yeah. Get that selfie. Whew. Kale McCarr.
Come on in. You're in the center.
He's back. Sorry, I just got to throw.
Thanks for coming out here into the heat. We know it is. Listen, we almost don't even want to be out here. So
we wanted to put you in the most excruciatingly hot situation for this.
Yeah.
How are you doing?
Good, yeah. Good. Nice little day off here, so works out well.
Casual awards ceremony on your day off after a game three.
Got bigger things to focus on here, but we'll enjoy the night and have fun.
Well, you're here. You're here for a reason. Congratulations on a heck of a season. I mean, this has been such an incredible year in general for defensemen. I mean, when you see the numbers that guys are putting up, what do you make of it? Because it's been really exciting for fans.
Yeah, I mean, it's amazing. It's awesome for us to just have all this competition in the league. I mean, you're surrounded by such great people tonight as well. And for us as D-men, I mean, those guys push me to be better every single day during the season. So that's all I can say for sure.
And tell us what you're wearing.
Yes.
I'll detail the suit.
nothing too crazy. I just actually, O'Connor's Calgary. Logan O'Connor on our team. His family runs a suit shop in Calgary.
Does.
So
there's a nice little plug
for them.
Right?
There you go.
What is it called again?
O'Connor's suit menswear, I think. O'Connor's menswear. So
nice. Yeah, they'll find it.
People will get there. So.
I know. So who do you want to get a selfie with tonight here?
Oh man, I don't know. I showed up with Joe, so maybe him, but Joe Sakic.
You can call him Joe.
Well, he said that if Nathan MacKinnon was going to be in a movie, he would be Clint Eastwood. Did I ask you about that the other day? Who you would cast?
I don't know if you asked me about myself. I don't know who Clint Eastwood's pretty accurate. I feel like for Nate, that's a good one. I don't know about myself though. I haven't really thought about that.
So. Yeah, you haven't thought about who's going to play Kale McCarr in the biopic.
No.
Can't be thinking about that too far ahead. It's too focused on being a couple wins away from a potential Stanley Cup. But you're here tonight. Are you a speech guy? Is that something that would make you nervous? Would you be like a funny speech guy, an emotional speech guy? Like, what kind of a speech would we get from you if you were to make your way up there tonight?
I mean, I'm pretty calm, so probably something pretty fast and then get right out of there. He's a pretty funny guy.
I got the scoop on him from Johnny Lazarus.
I don't know about that.
Yeah, big office quotes.
No jokes will be cracked.
You don't have some one-liners up there ready?
Yeah. Straight to the point. Thanks a lot.
Exactly.
See you later.
So you go in there, you do the awards, and then what's the game plan after that? Because you got a big game for tomorrow.
Yeah, just get prepared, I guess. Have a good night's sleep and then be ready to go. So.
All right, well, listen, congratulations. We won't keep you out here any longer.
Thanks, Kale.
We know how hot it is, so thank you.
Yes, have a good one. We really appreciate it.
Get inside.
That's Kale McCarr. He's up for the Norris Trophy and also in the Stanley Cup. Wow. Your life's just like you'd be, that's like Brad Pitt or Leonardo DiCaprio, basically. It's like when you're so warranted and wanted, and we're swimming out here.
I don't think you guys understand quite how bad it is.
I think we just need
bad
to do
it is. How are you?
Do you
have 2 seconds?
I love how
we're just like, it's so hot.
Hello, Mark. Very nice to meet you.
Mark, we are melting out here.
Where's the shade?
Nobody better ever say that I don't give this business my all, all right?
This is a bad hair day for me. I'm uncontrollable with this humidity.
Yeah, we wanted it. We wanted the toughest test, just like you. You've been through a lot.
Oh, God.
The toughest test. Exactly.
Yeah, well, tell us what you're wearing here at the NHL Awards.
Well, I'm not quite sure, actually. It's a little custom-made suit from Alan David. So
there you go.
Yeah, so it's
nice. I like the comfortable footwear choice.
Yeah, a little casual.
Yeah.
It's a far departure from the tuxedos that we used to wear when we first started doing the awards. Yeah. But
it's
I'm not getting an award today,
yeah,
so
yeah,
I can dress it down now. Yeah.
Who are you excited to see potentially win an award tonight? So many incredible performances.
For me, honestly, I came today because I love hearing the speeches. I love hearing how...
You're a speech guy!
I do, and I actually get emotional because it's so amazing to hear the journeys of these players and what they've gone through and their parents and the people that have helped put them in these situations there. It's always so inspiring to me.
Yeah.
So you know, I'm not obligated to be here to do anything, but I always want to come here just to hear it and see it. Yeah.
To see this moment. Okay, so you've been doing a great job broadcasting for ESPN this year.
Well, thank you very much.
Covering the Stanley Cup.
We love seeing you.
It's been a big learning curve,
yeah,
but it's
like
been
what's,
fun.
What was Mark Messier at the beginning of the season like to now in terms of broadcasting? How do you feel?
Well, I know a lot more. You know, I think one of the challenges I had early on is that I was always trying to backstop every point I was trying to make with a lot of information, and you just don't have enough time. So you got to really articulate a point very quickly and be very clear on what you're trying to talk about. And so, but ESPN has been amazing. Steve Levy has been a real professional. Everybody behind the cameras, from the producers, have been really supportive of Chris and I. But you know, we've stumbled a few times, but that's what happens when
you're. That's part of the fun.
That's part of the fun too.
So you just go,
yeah, exactly.
Julie almost fell into the rocks earlier.
Well, let's move over.
We don't want that to happen. Yeah.
You're working with Chelly. What would be like a duo, or like how would you describe your relationship with him to people that don't know what it's like between you two?
Well, you know, it's amazing. I played against Chelly for all those years, but we never played in the same conference, and we never played against each other in the playoffs. And all the
That's
so odd, right? I shouldn't say we haven't played in the same conference, but we never played against each other in the playoffs.
Okay.
So we never had that really intense battle that I know we would have if we would have played it, because of the competitor that he is. So we have a lot of laughs, and of course, you know, Chelly's such a great guy, and
got a wooden leg.
What a warrior! Yeah. And we're having a good time. Yeah.
Well, it's not often that I get to chat with you, Mark. So I got to get your thoughts on this Stanley Cup final. The Bolts get a big win last night. Do you think that's a turning point in the series, or is it still the Avs to lose?
Well, it was interesting to see the first two games, because I don't think anybody saw the second game coming.
Yeah.
Especially with the Tampa Bay over the last few years, what we've seen Tampa Bay be able to do is really kind of change their game and bring teams into what they do well. They weren't able to do that in the first two series. In fact, Colorado played exactly the kind of game that they knew they needed to play, with that fast transition game with all their skill. They come home to Tampa, and sure enough, Tampa clamps it down a little bit. It muddies the water, slows the game down. Vasilevsky plays well. It was kind of tight going in and out for the first period there, but ultimately Tampa Bay did what they needed to do. It wasn't pretty at times, but they did what they needed to do. They got the win, and now who knows what's going to happen in Game 4.
Yeah, well, you saw Tampa Bay do what they needed to do against the New York Rangers. We're seeing Igor Shesterkin here tonight. What do you think about, like, what grade would you give the Rangers this season and how they finished?
It was incredible. As a former alumni, as an analyst, as a guy that watches a lot of hockey, I was just pulled into the Rangers storyline this year. I love watching the team. I like the feeling that you got watching the players. They had a great chemistry, they had great camaraderie, they seemed to really like to play with each other. They have a really great nucleus by some superstars on the team, emerging superstars on the team, and I picked them to win the division this year, and everybody thought I was crazy.
To win the cup.
Yeah, everybody thought I was crazy because, you know, they didn't think they were ready yet. And
isn't it nice when that works out? You're like,
well,
right.
They didn't win the division, but they did have an amazing run in the playoffs, but They're set up well for the future, and you know, you need a great goalie. They got it. You need a Norris Trophy defenseman. They got that. You know, they got really good, strong depth up front, and as long as they can sign some players and keep it together, who knows what's going to happen? But it's really exciting.
The nice little Kreider's advantage-eyed bromance is also awesome to see.
That is a bromance, isn't it?
Oh, the iPad, the iPad thing will live forever.
Yeah.
Like Kreider throwing the iPad.
Yeah, it's awesome. Yeah. It's awesome.
It was fun watching them this
year. Yeah, so it was. I really enjoyed it, yeah.
All right, well, listen, we'll let you get inside. We know it's hot.
Yeah.
So thank you for hanging out with
Mark,
us and stopping by. We appreciate
a real pleasure
it.
To have you here on Stanley Cup Live.
Thank you
Not
so much.
Every day we get a legend like you.
I know.
Show.
Holy moly.
Holy
All right. Thank
well,
you so much.
Great to be
much.
Here, everybody. Cheers.
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 Cheers. Cheers.
Microphone cheers.
Hand your mic to Matt off to the side there on your way in.
Yeah.
Enjoy the show.
Bye, Mark. Really nice to meet you.
Oh, my goodness.
All right. He is great. What a legend. Okay, well, you know what, guys? We actually have the award show coming up right now on ESPN, Sportsnet, TVOut, wherever you're watching from, 7 p.m., and it's going to be absolutely fantastic.
I can't wait.
I can't wait. Thanks
Leafs
for joining
gonna
us.
Leafs are going to win something this year.
Leafs are going to win something.
Hey! Thanks for watching Stanley Cup Live, presented by New
Amsterdam
Vodka.
I
need a water.
We'll see you on... I need a vodka. I need a New Amsterdam Vodka.
Let's get both.
Mm-hmm.
Bye.